بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد. So inshallah a brief recap of what we've done so far. So we've covered كلمة and the كلمة how many types are they? Three, which are? اسم فعل حرف. اسم, how is اسم recognized? How is it recognized? تنوين or?
Name
or? Alif Lam. So if it's Alif Lam or تنوين or if it's a name, it'll be an isam. Fail, you recognize from the patterns that as you're covering more and more. And harf, how do you recognize harf?
It's a two
letter. Yeah, for now the rule is if you've got two letters or one letter, consider it to be a harf. And then harf and the isam, we discussed how many characteristics. So the first characteristic of a na'an is either going to be what? Ma'rifah or? Yeah. It's going to be nakira. The second characteristic that we started yesterday was either going to be mudhakkar or mu'annath. Yeah, is that clear? Mu'annath, how do you recognize mu'annath?
The ta' marbuta.
Has a ta' around ta', or the other way of recognizing it is?
By nature.
Has a gen is actually female, for example. Ummun, which means?
Mother.
Mother, sister, yeah. Any word like that. So, you had these 10 words. Kalima, isam, fa'al, harf, ma'rifa, nakira, mudhakkar, mu'annath. And as I mentioned before, the characteristics are four. You have four characteristics. We've covered two. And today, inshallah, I want to cover a bit of the third characteristic. Okay? The third characteristic of a noun is number. Number meaning singular, plural. Yeah, so one more than one number. We're going to be discussing this today, inshallah, a bit of this. So, in English, you have what? Singular. And singular means what? One. And the opposite of singular is plural. Correct? Now, singular means one, and plural means more than one. So for example, you have the word book. Book refers to a single unit. This is called singular. And if you have more than one, it's called books. And in English, you call, in Arabic, you call singular what? Wahid. Wahid. Okay? That's the word for singular. If you ever get confused, remember, like Allahu Wahid. Allah is one, so you use that as a Wahidun. So Wahid means what? Singular. And plural is Jam'un. Some people say Jama'. So it's not a big deal, but it's really jam'un. The pronunciation is what? Jam'un. Okay? Correct? So you have wahid and jama'. Until here, it's fine. No problem. Correct?
Yeah.
Any English speaker will have no problem relating to this. However, the Arabs, as you Arabic language, they like to avoid excessive speech or adding on things without necessity. So, if you look at it, the word two, if you want to say, for example, five, you have to say, for example, five books. Make sense? So anytime you want to add a particular number to something, you have to add the word 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, etc. to the noun. 7 books, 8 books, 9 books. Now, 3 is not that. They would say, for example, you won't say 7 books. I mean, how often is 7 used? I mean, you use it, but it's not like everyday thing. And to us, singular is either one or more than one. But in Arabic language, Arabs thought, you know what, 2 is used quite frequently as well. You often say 2 people, because you talk about one the most, or more than one. But two is also quite commonly used. So what they've done is they devised a separate word for jewel. A separate word for two, which is called jewel. So instead of having to say two books, so for example, when I say book, automatically I mean one book. It's not going to refer to more than one book. And when I say books, automatically I mean more than one book. Okay? But then instead of saying, and if I want to say two books in English, I would have to say two books. But the Arabs have devised a special formula. And they say there is something called singular. Fine, it's plural, fine. It's also something called jewel. That a one word, without adding the word two, it can show two. Okay, so without actually adding the word two before a word, you can actually get the meaning of two. It's like two. Okay, so for example, two books. Okay, and this is called what? Tathniya. So now what happens? Single, in according to Arabs, wahid means what? One. Jama' is what? Plural, not more than one, but what? More than two. In English, you say more than one because obviously when you have singular and plural, we don't have a jewel. We use the word jewel, but it's not actual tense for jewel. Yeah? You following? So, more than two is what you call jam'un. And if it's two, you call it what? Tathniya. So, what are the three key words you have to learn here today? Wahid, the singular. Tathniya is jewel. And jam' is plural. What are the three words again?
Wahid,
tathniya, and jam'. واحد تثنية جمع. واذي؟
واحد تثنية جمع.
Correct? Good. So, how do we make these words? So, wahid. Now, wahid, this is the normal form you get. It's what you find in a dictionary. For example, if you're looking up, let's say, for example, man. Now, if you look under man, you find the word rajul. That's a singular word. And the plural will be rijal. You have a dictionary for that. Now, obviously, you might get confused. For example, you see a word in the Quran. Let's say, for example, fihi rijalun. Now, you will not know, maybe at the beginning, is rijalun singular or plural. So, as you start studying and using dictionary, you have to figure out how it is. But there's no rule for identifying the wahid and certain plurals. So, that's something you're going to go into. You just know, for example, in our books, you'll have the vocab list, singular, plural. So then you'll know, okay, this is a singular form, this is a plural form. As far as jewel is concerned, a jewel follows a rule, a set pattern. Okay? To make a word jewel, there are two rules. Okay? What are they? There are two rules. The first is you make it by placing a fatha on the last letter of the wahid. You place a fatha on the last letter. Fatha we call zabar in Urdu. A fatha on the last letter of the wahid. And then you add an alif and a noon. But the noon has a kasra. So basically, ani. So you give the last letter of the original word, a fatha, and you add an. Let me explain to you. So for example, we have here, sahir. Okay, what do we have? Okay, now this is a singular word, isn't it? Now how do you make this plural? First step is, place a fatha on the last letter of the wahid. So sahirun, what you remove the dhamma, and you add what? A fatha. Sahira. Yeah. So instead of sahiru, it becomes sahira. And after that, you add an alif and a noon, and the noon have a kasra, a zir. So then, ani. So sahirun becomes sahirani. And that's a plural. So any word of the ani, it becomes what? Becomes jewel. Yeah? So how is the jewel made? By adding the word, the suffix. Ani. Suffix means something that comes at the end of the word. So by adding ani, and ani means the fatha on the last letter, and then ani. So anything that has ani at the end is going to be what? Jewel. So, to make the jewel, you add ani. However, make a note here. If it's a feminine word, the jewel... So a feminine word has what at the end? Ta marbuta. Okay? But when you make this jewel, it kind of gets a bit mixed up between the ta marbuta and ta maftuha. Let me explain. Okay? Look at this. Ta'ifatun. The plural of that is going to be, jewel of that is going to be what? Ta'ifa, tani. Correct? Now if you look at this ta compared to a normal ta, you can't tell the difference anymore. For example, baytun means house. This is ta marbuta or ta maftuha? Ta maftuha, the open ta. Okay? And ummatun, that ta is what? Marbuta. When you make this jewel, what happens? It becomes baytan. And it becomes ummatan. Now these two ta, the marbuta and the maftuha, the wahid, written the same way.
Can we say it's become maftuha?
You wouldn't say that, but what I'm saying is that when it's written in the jewel form, it doesn't have any form. It is both the same. So now you have to be careful, and you have to make sure you look back to the wahid if you're unsure. Because like ummatun, you okay? Ummatun is what? Is nation, and that's feminine. So obviously the jewel is also going to be feminine. Now don't say, well, it's got ta'ani, that's why it's feminine. Because that ta is not really from the ta marbuta, it's really from the ta maftuha. You get what I'm saying? Yes. So, just because you have a ta here, just because this, the ta marbuta, is written like this, and that's the ta maftuha, they're both written the same way. These two ta's are the same. You following? So, because they're exactly the same, some people get confused in certain instances. It's not maftuha, but it's not maftuha. That's feminine because the singular is feminine. Yes. So, what I'm saying, the ta marbuta changes its form when it's written in the middle. Okay, so it might be a bit hard to recognize, or you might get mixed up between ta maftuha.
So ta marbuta is only at the end?
Yes, only at the end. When it's not in the end, it's not a marbuta anymore. It's not written round anymore.
How about if it's, for example, Maryam, so it hasn't got ta marbuta, but it's feminine, and there's two of them, two Maryams?
Then you will know from the mean that Maryam is the same rule as before. It's a new natural gender.
So,
for example, it's ukhtun. The ukhtun is also written with ta maftuha. When you make that jewel, it'll be ukhtani. And it's feminine not because of ta marbuta, but because of the meaning.
Let's say Maryam, so it's a meme at the end. So how would Maryam man?
Yeah, Maryam man. Okay. Yep. Your ummun, for example. So mother. So you say ummani. Yeah? Make sense? Yep. Everybody following me?
Yep.
Okay? Shall we practice a bit? So this is the ayah of the Quran. Yadahu mabasutatani. Let's start right from the beginning. Is it ism? Is it a kalima, mabasutatan? Is it an ism?
No.
No, why not? Correct. According to the previous rule, yes, has no alif lam, no tanween. But however, we know that the ani is the way you make a noun dual.
Right.
You get what I'm saying? So it's also now, we can say, well, another sign of being a noun is what? That it has ani in it.
Yeah.
Make sense? So yes, your first theory was correct. You made a mistake, but according to a good theory, that there's no alif lam, no tanween. So, correct, if there's no alif lam, no tanween. But now we studied a bit later on that, well, to make a noun dual, what do you add on? Ani. So the ani then obviously is also a sign of, to a certain extent, it's also a sign of
ism.
So this is an ism, correct? Now what's the characteristic number one? Is it ma'rifah or nakira?
It's
everything gets thrown upside down today, huh?
It's ma'rifah.
Why is it ma'rifah?
Because there's two of them.
So? Let's say for example, I say, oh, there are two men. There are two men in the shop. I don't know who they are about. I don't know who they are. There's two men. It is a healthy ma'rifah just because they are two.
Because of yaddahu.
No. This word on its own.
It doesn't have the sign of either ma'rifah or nakira.
Okay. It doesn't have the sign of?
Ma'rifah.
Ma'rifah?
Yeah. Or nakira. Because
okay, fine.
Because the al, one is the
name. Correct. Good argument. So you're saying it has no sign of ma'rifah or no sign of nakira. Fine. What's the sign of ma'rifah?
The al.
Al. There's no al. Correct? Now, is there a sign of nakira? No. But the thing is, the sign of a nakira, the space of nakira has been occupied now, isn't it? But this, if you wanted to add alif lam, you could have added alif lam. You can't add a tanween on this. So now, we will say one step further, we could say that in dual, if it has alif lam, it's what? If it has no alif lam, it's? Even if it doesn't have a tanween. Get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So obviously, I said, the rules you learned day one is all these hints they had to get by. Now we say, well, it's something new now. So yes, alif lam is a sign of ma'rifah, tanween is a sign of nakira. But in a jewel doesn't carry tanween. A jewel never has tanween.
Yeah.
Remember that rule, yeah? Because I'm warning in advance. A trick question will come up later on. Jewel does not have tanween. So if it doesn't have, if it has alif lam, it's going to be?
Ma'rifah.
And no alif lam is?
Nakira.
You don't look at tanween in jewel, because tanween doesn't carry jewel doesn't carry tanween anyways. Yeah. So what is this going to be in terms of gender? What is this now, gender? So yeah, first ma'rifah nakira. What is this now?
Nakira.
Why?
Because there's no al.
There's no alif lam. Good. Second characteristic is what? Mudhakkar or mu'annath. So is it mudhakkar or is it mu'annath? It's mu'annath because of the?
Ta.
Good. And in terms of number and gender, is it wahid or is it jewel? Wahid or tasniyah?
It is singular.
Why is it singular?
I'm not too sure what it is.
Where is it going to be?
Tasniyah.
Why is it tasniyah?
Yeah, because it's jewel because of the ta and the alif.
Not the ta alif, the alif and the noon.
Alif and the noon even. And the letter before has a fatha.
Yeah, so this is alif fatha alif noon means that what this is going to be?
Jewel.
Okay. This one. Is it ism? Is it an ism?
Yeah.
Why?
Tanween.
So we know it's ism. The first characteristic of an ism is what? First characteristic we have to look at is?
It is ma'rifah or
nakira. Is it ma'rifah or is it nakira?
Nakira.
Because? Tanween. Second characteristic, is it masculine or is it feminine?
Masculine.
It's masculine because?
No tamarbuta.
Is it singular or is it jewel?
It's jewel.
Why is it jewel?
Because of the alif.
Alif?
Yeah.
And the?
Noon.
Is it singular or is it jewel? This word. I told you, I warned you in advance. I warned you. Yeah? So yes, it has alif noon, but this noon is what?
It's part of the word.
It's part of the word. It's got tanween. That means that's not additional an.
Mm-hmm.
Because remember I told you before, a jewel cannot have tanween. So the tanween means that this is not ani, because ani. The tanween means what now? That this is part of the original. It's, the bohtanun is one word. Do you understand? Bohtanun is one word. Do you understand? So this is going to be what? Singular, wahid al-tasniyah? Wahid. Azim, is it isam?
Yeah.
What kind of isam? Ma'rifah nakira?
Nakira.
Is it muzakkar or mu'annath?
It's muzakkar.
Why is it muzakkar?
There's no ta'am
marbut. Is it wahid or is it jama'?
Wahid.
Wahid or tasniyah?
Wahid.
Wahid. Every word in here we can do, mashallah. Gee, let's start from here. Are these all nouns?
I think
all apart from?
The middle one.
Middle is 1, 2, 3, 4, okay. But this one, wow, is 1 as well, so it's 6, so it can't be middle.
Okay, well, an.
An is a, is what?
Is a joining.
So what is it called? Harf. What else?
The waw.
The waw, wa shimalin. That's also a harf. So that's 2 harfs are out. Are there any verbs? Can you notice any verbs on the, what you studied so far? Any verbs? No. So, we have all nouns here, correct? Because it's, okay. So let's start with this one. Is it ma'rifah or is it nakira? It's ma'rifah. Why?
Because of the tanween.
Oh, yeah, I'll wait for a while, yes.
I can never remember the Arabic terminology. Yeah, so it's ma'rifah.
You can't remember the Arabic terminology, I'll give you a clue. Nakira is indefinite. Nakira is indefinite. So this is?
Indefinite.
Indefinite, so it's going to be? Indefinite is going to be? Nakira.
The reason being, because you've got the tanween.
You've got a tanween. The second characteristic, is it muzakkar or is it mu'annath?
Mu'annath.
Why is it mu'annath? At-ta'u al-marbuta. Is it wahid or is it jam'a tasniya?
Wahid.
Yep. Okay. Next word. First characteristic.
It's feminine.
No, ma'rifah nakira.
Ma'rifah nakira.
It's nakira. No, there's no tanween. So then?
So it's Marifa.
Marifa.
No,
Marifa's.
Yeah, so it's Nakira.
I've really put you in a true summer. So is it Marifa or is it Nakira?
It's Nakira.
But it's no Tanween.
No Tanween. It's because
yeah.
There's no Al. Al would be a sign of Marifa.
So is it
Marifa
or Nakira?
Nakira.
Are you sure? Yes. But it's no Tanween.
It's been occupied by the.
Yes. So in Jewel, the sign of Marifa and Nakira is Alif Lam being there or not being there. Is it Alif Lam here? No. So no alif lam means?
Nakira.
It's nakira. Okay. So first characteristic is done. It's nakira.
Yeah.
Right? Second characteristic, is it muzakkar or is it mu'annath?
It is male.
Male. Why do you say it's male?
Hang on. It's female because of the ta.
Yes. So that ta marbuta opened up now. And written like this.
It's mu'annath.
It's mu'annath.
So how would you really stick
to? How would you know? Because when you know the single, what's the single of jannatan? What is Jannatun and the Jannah, when you see the single is of Ta'am Marbuta. Mm-hmm. So it is made from Jannatun. Is it Wahid or is it Tasniyah?
Tasniyah.
Why is it Tasniyah?
Because the Ani.
What's the Wahid of this?
Jannatun.
Take the Ani off and make the Ta'am into the Dhamma. Jannatun. Yameenin. Is it Ma'rifah Nakira?
So it's Nakira.
Why?
Tanween.
Is it Muzakkar or Mu'annath? Mu'adhakkar. Is it wahid or tasniya?
It's wahid.
Wahid. And shimal, is it ma'rifa nakira?
Nakira.
Why?
Tanween.
Is it muzakkar or mu'annath?
Muzakkar.
And is it? Last question. Wahid or tasniya?
Wahid.
Wahid. Nice one. Again, they get longer, don't worry. Okay, your turn. Is it ma'rifa nakira? Ma'rifa, why?
Because
okay, is it muzakkar or mu'annath? Muzakkar, why?
Because there's no ta'am.
There's no ta'am marbuta. Is it wahid or tathniya?
Wahid.
Wahid. You start this time, bismillah. So, marratan, is it
nakira.
Is it ma'rifa nakira?
Nakira.
Nakira, why is it nakira?
No,
but it's no tanween.
You don't have to, in jewel you wouldn't have tanween.
So then what do you look at the German ma'rifa nakira?
Alif Lam.
There's no Alif Lam, so it has to be?
Nakira.
Nakira. In second characteristic is gender. Is it muzakkar or mu'annath?
Muzakkar.
Why?
Because the open ta and then the
ami. Because the ta was originally marratun. And is it wahid or is it tathniya? Why is it tathniya?
Ani.
Fa, so wa is a marifa nakira? Fa.
Neither because it's a particle.
It's a harf, it is a curry, that categorization. Next one is imsakun. Is it marifa nakira?
Nakira.
Why is it nakira tanmeen? Mudhakkar mu'annath?
Mudhakkar.
And is it mudhakkar or mu'annath? Mudhakkar. And the last one is it wahid or tasniya?
Wahid.
B?
B is a particle.
Particle, so there's no categorization. Ma'roof, ma'rifa nakira?
It is nakira.
Nakira? Mudhakkar mu'annath?
Mu'annath.
Why mu'annath?
It's mudhakkar even, it's male.
Mudhakkar even?
It's...
It can only be one of them.
It's mudhakkar.
It's mudhakkar, good. And wahid or tathniya? Wahid. Or?
Harf.
Tasrihun?
It would be nakira.
Nakira? Next one is mudhakkar muannath?
Mudhakkar.
Wahid tasniya?
Wahid.
Ihsanin?
Nakira.
Nakira?
Mudhakkar.
Tathniya. Tathniya. You agree?
Yeah.
You agree?
Yes.
You agree?
No.
Why don't you agree? Why are you making a fight? Why are you causing a fight in class for?
Because
it's tanween. Tanween. I told you, I warned you. Jewel does not have tanween. Both of you fell for it. What's that going to be? That's wahid. The ihsanin is one word.
Mashallah.
The ihsanin is one word. Because if it was a plural, it'd be if the word for example was ihsa, it'd be ihsani, not ihsanin. But ihsan is one word because the Jew does not have tanween. So that's what? What is that going to be?
Wahid.
And you got it? Okay, only a few in here. Jarun. Jarun. Go through all the categorizations quickly.
Nakira
ka tanween.
It's a singular.
It's mudhakkar mu'annath first.
It's a mudhakkar.
Mm-hmm.
No karambuta. And it's wahid.
Wahid. Next.
It is. It's definite.
Definite is. So definite is called what?
Definite is ma'rifa.
Ma'rifa.
It is male, which is mudhakkar.
Why?
It is feminine.
Mu'annath,
because it's got the ta.
Yes.
And it is jewel because of the ani.
And what's jewel called in Arabic? Tathniya. And what's this?
Harf.
Nakasa? How do you know the fail?
Pattern.
Pattern, what's the pattern?
Madi.
Fa'ala. Okay. Right. Dakhala? Dakhala?
Fail.
Go through a categorization of this one. No, you go through this one. Yeah, Sid. All three.
Ma'rifa.
Mudhakkar.
Wahid.
Nakira.
Mudhakkar.
Tathniya. What about this ta?
It's just part of the...
Yeah, because it's not... It comes... It doesn't come at the end. It comes before the ya. If it was after the ya, before the ani, then you might say it's feminine. So good, you didn't call it feminine. This one?
It's nakira.
Mm-hmm.
It's
nakira, good. Second?
Mudhakkar.
For now, I'll let you go on that one. It's mudhakkar, yes, for now.
And it's wahid.
Wahid. This one? Is it?
Hang on, no, it's the other one. Because of the
L. Yeah, you have to get those terminologies.
Ma'rifa.
Well,
ma'rifa. It's ma'rifa. It's male.
It's mudhakkar, male.
And it is singular.
It's singular.
Wahid.
Khubzan?
It's ma'rifa nakira. It is wahid and mudhakkar.
Mudhakkar.
معرفة مذكر واحد.
Okay.
نكرة تثني مذكر.
مذكر تثنية مذكر. تثنية مذكر النكرة. Good. من؟ فعل. لفظ الجلالة؟ Sorry, you got me saying the wrong thing as well now. Min is what? Not fail.
Oh, yeah,
harf,
it's
harf.
It's the two letters.
Yes, لفظ الجلالة. لفظ الجلالة is? اسم فعل حرف. Allah. اسم. Why are you confusing that one?
Oh, yes, it's a noun.
It's a noun. Okay, this one. الباب.
معرفة.
معرفة.
مذكر.
مذكر.
واحد.
واحد. نكرة.
نكرة.
نكرة. مذكر مؤنث.
مؤنث.
And.
And تثنية.
تثنية. من.
حرف.
فعل.
It's a harf.
شهداء. Okay, leave شهداء for now. إذا الأخرى already. إذا. إذا. ما. حرف. صغيرا.
نكرة.
مذكر
واحد.
واحد.
نكرة مذكر.
نكرة مذكر أن.
واحد.
إلى.
حرف.
شهادة. لو شهادة.
It is. معرفة.
معرفة because of.
الألف.
الإفلام. So the ألف. So look, here another point to notice is that when the lam comes on a word of ألف لام, the ألف drops and only lam remains. So you have lam ألف لام. You have lam. Alif is removed and you have Al-Shahada. It's Ma'rifah. So even though it's not Alif Lam, it's a Lam. Okay? And this is... Okay, then you have Ma'rifah Nakira. Ma'rifah.
It's Mu'annath. And it's singular.
Singular is called?
Wahid.
Wahid. This one?
Nakira.
Nakira.
Mu'annath.
مؤنث
واحد.
واحد. شو؟ أريكا كلمة اسم فعل حرف. اسم is what?
اسم is a noun.
فعل
is a verb.
Verb and حرف
particle.
And اسم now we have how many characteristics? One is what?
معرفة
نكرة. Number two is مذكر مؤنث. And number three is واحد تثنية and جماع. We leave جماع tomorrow inshallah or next week. And تثنية is we cover is جوال. And in فعل الحرف. Yeah.
Yeah.
Any questions? Yeah.
Okay. And so the sign of jewel even is the fatha on the letter before and then the alif and then the nun.
Yes. Ani.
Yeah.
Ani. And the sign of ma'rifa is what? Alif lam or name. Sign of nakira is? Except on?
Except
on jewel. What's the sign of what's the sign of a nakira on tasniya? Not having a sign of ma'rifah, not having alif lam. Okay? Good? Subhanallah, bihamdi, subhanakallahumma, bihamdika, wa nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, wa nastaghfiruka wa natubu.